welcome to day two of the NAB AFL Draft Combine here at Marvel Stadium. I'm Jen Feel and I'm joined here by Cal Toomey. Cal, yesterday was all about introductions and getting their kit and just getting settled in. Today, a little bit more action for the boys.
Yeah, a little bit more action, Jen. Good to have you on board. It's day two at the NAB AFL Draft Combine. Today was all about medical screenings earlier in the day, so clubs' medical teams are able to go and assess the prospects that they're interested in, see if there's any flaws in that body technique or how those knees are recovered from surgeries, all that sort of thing, just to double check on how these guys are looking heading into the draft. So obviously the clubs invest so much money and resources into their prospects that they pick up, so they want to know what they're getting and if there are any issues with that. So they're able to do that this morning. I also had many chats with players at club interviews. So speaking to some players today, some were having chats with up to 12 clubs today, so they're all talked out. Getting a lot of familiar questions, but there has been some coaches in the house. We've seen John Longmire from the Swans, seen Dom Pike from Adelaide as well, and the Western Bulldogs coach Luke Beveridge is here as well. So some coaches floating through and getting a chat with the players, as have the media. So plenty of interviews being done today. It's media day, basically, at the NAB AFL Draft Combine. And tonight, the kicking and goal kicking test will get underway here on the surface at Marvel Stadium.
I bet you they can't wait to get the balls out and actually do something that doesn't involve using their brain. I can imagine it'd be a pretty mentally exhausting day with all that chatting.
Long day for them, isn't it? Yeah. But I think they're pretty excited to get out there and, as you said, just get the footies out because that's what they're here for.
Today was also a bit of a father-son feel to things. We'll start with Bailey Scott. He had a chat to the media before. He's got a pretty big decision to make because he's actually eligible to go to three different clubs. Let's hear about whether or not he's actually made his decision.
I sort of just put the decision to the back of my head through the year, allow me to play some football and hopefully have a good year, and then also just keep sticking to studies and passing my subjects at uni. So it hasn't really hit me yet, but I'm sure in the next couple of weeks that there'll be a lot going through my head. But obviously I've got people around me that are really good support, and I'll talk with them and I'll be able to make a decision.
And Cal, what do you think? Where do you think he'll end up?
I'm not sure where he'll end up. It's obviously a three-horse race, and obviously the Cats and North Melbourne are in it, where his father Robert played, and the Gold Coast as well as an academy player, given he's lived in Queensland in that zone for more than 5 years. So the ties of home would have to be a pretty big one, I imagine. So the Suns would have some level of confidence that he's going to choose them. But the other two clubs are certainly in the fight for him as well. Look, he's somewhere in the draft ballpark, I'd imagine, from pick 25 to 40, around that sort of spot. Outside midfielder, good runner of the footy, and good user of the footy too. Really hard-working player, but certainly in that second round, I'd imagine, on draft night.
Well, it's nice for him to have a little bit of a choice, a bit of an option
there. Yeah, half his luck.
Yeah, well, things are probably a little bit simpler for Riley West, the son of famous Bulldog and seven-time Best and Fairest winner Scott. He is obviously eligible to be drafted this year as well. He's here testing at the Combine, and he also spoke to media today.
Oh, I haven't had much contact with the Bulldogs, so I guess it's a bit up in the air for me still, and I guess they probably know what they want to do, but I don't really know at the moment, so I guess it's a bit of a hard question to answer.
Would you be disappointed if you didn't get there?
I guess at the end of the day, it's all about getting on an AFL list, so as long as it's on another AFL list, I can't see any disappointment in that.
So, Cal, it's probably fair to assume that the Dogs want him. He's a highly, highly talented junior. What do you think they're going to have to pay to get him?
Yeah, I think they'll probably have to give up a second-round pick, but the bid will probably come somewhere around that sort of 15 to 25 mark for Riley West, I'd imagine. He's sort of in that second group of midfielders. Looks so dogged around the ball. He's tenacious.
Pardon
he's got a bit
pun.
Of... Yeah, it's pardon the pun. He's so tenacious with the footy. Loves a tackle. Loves a sidestep. He's pretty small on the lighter side, but certainly makes his disposals count. So I've seen him play a lot of footy this year. A consistent ball winner. Somewhere in that end of first round / early second round. Won't cost the Bulldogs their first pick, so you don't have to worry about that.
Well, the Dogs have obviously had a fair bit of success lately with the father-sons. Mm. Also, the Cats have as well. They've had quite a few go through their club in the past 10 years. Oscar Brownless is one that they have available to them this year. It's a little bit of rivalry between Oscar and his famous dad, Billy. Let's hear what he had to say today.
He loves telling us all about the goal after the siren. Does he get out the VHS and show you?
Oh, yeah, every night pretty much. There's a while there. When it comes around finals time, you know it's going to come out, and I can tell you it word for word right now. We've listened and watched it that many times.
Surely your goal earlier in the MCG for Vic Country, you got bragging rights now over that goal, haven't you?
Yeah, I'll certainly take it to him with that, because I don't reckon he could have kicked that back in his day. He was pretty much just all set shots and drop punts, and yeah, there's a bit of a debate going on there.
So, Cal, what do you think? Which one was better?
I'm going to go with Oscar. because he's in this year's draft pool. But
fair enough.
But he didn't have the crowd behind him quite like Billy did. So he probably lived up to the moment, Billy.
Right. Well, quite seriously, though, where do you think that he's going to fall in the draft? What's he going to cost the Cats?
I think he's probably later end selection. He's done a great job this year playing for the Geelong Falcons and Vic Country as well. Playing through the midfield as a running carry player. Probably needs to sharpen up his disposal a little bit, but I really like the way he's attacked the footy. Just keeps going and going. So somewhere sort of 45 onwards for me for Oscar Brownless, and should get to the Cats, which would be great.
Yeah, well, we love a father-son story.
And we love Billy Brownless as well. We love the theatre that he brings to the game. It'd be great to see his son out there.
The club, I'm sure he would love to see his son running around in the hoops as well. As we mentioned before, some of the physical testing will get underway later tonight. Cal, what can we expect from day 3 tomorrow?
Day 3, well, we see the testing going on at the moment. This is just a couple of kids giving it a bit of a run-through, giving that floor a bit of a test. But tomorrow we'll see the agility, the sprints, the jumping test as well. So we'll have all the results on afl.com.au tomorrow.
Well, I bet you they're jumping out of their skin to actually do something physical, as we mentioned before. Cal, thanks again for joining us.
Thanks,
and
Jim.
Thank you for watching. You can check back on afl.com.au and the AFL Live app for all the NAB AFL Draft Combine news.